So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB Current Affairs, where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams. So let's begin with the session, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session, and you can also follow me here also. You can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question, which is regarding the very important scheme of the Government of India, that is MP LADS. So the question is, consider the following statements with respect to MP Local Area Development Scheme, which in short is MP LADS, and you have to identify the correct statement. Now this scheme, guys, is in news because the government has continued this scheme now. So the Union Cabinet has approved the continuation of this scheme for the remaining part of this financial year, that is financial year 2021-22 up to financial year 2026. All right, so Union Cabinet ne iska continuation approve kar diya hai for remaining part of this financial year, aur kab tak ke liye? Up to 2025-26. Now the question is, why this scheme was discontinued? Ye scheme discontinue kyun hui thi? See, remember, in the month of April 2020, owing to COVID-19, this scheme was discontinued, and it was decided that the funds of MP LADS scheme will be used in recovery of the country from COVID-19. Okay, but kyunki abhi hamari jo country hai, that is going on a good path, jo hamara economy hai wo acche se recover kar raha hai, and in fact it is back on the track. So that's why the government has decided to continue this particular scheme, which is known as MP LADS. All right. Now talking about the scheme, so remember, the scheme was launched in the year 1993 mein launch hui thi, and at the time of its launch, it was implemented by Ministry of Rural Development. But in the very next year, that is in the year 1994, the implementation responsibility of this scheme was transferred to Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. So this is very important. Do remember this fact, that the implementing ministry of this scheme is Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. Now what is the objective of this scheme? This scheme enables an MP to recommend works of developmental nature like drinking water infrastructure, sanitation, roads, primary education facility, primary health facilities. All right, and for this, each MP is allotted rupees 5 crores per year in two installments of rupees 2.5 crores. And also remember that this is a central sector scheme, which means it is 100% funded by the Government of India. Now talking about the financial implications for the extension of this scheme, jo ab aage ye scheme chalegi to uske kya kya financial implications honge. So remember, for the remaining part of this financial year, 2 crores will be provided to each MP. Rupees 2 crore will be provided to each MP in one installment. Lekin from the very next financial year, that is from financial year 23, kya hoga, wapas se jo 5 crore wala criteria hai wo wapas aa jayega, which means from financial year 23 to financial year 26, how much funds will be released? Rupees 5 crores, okay? 5 crore rupees in two installments of 2.5 crore each. 2.5 crores will be released to each MP, alright? And the total outlay for this period will be 17,417 crores. 17,417 crore rupees ka total outlay hoga starting from this financial year to financial year 2026, okay? So this was about this news, guys, and now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct statement. The scheme is being implemented by the Ministry of Rural Development. No, when it was launched, it was implemented by Ministry of Rural Development, but now it is being implemented by Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation, which means the statement is incorrect. It has been continued till financial year 2026. Yes, this is absolutely correct. For the remaining period of this financial year, that is 22, rupees 3 crore per MP will be released. So is that so? Rupees 3 crores will be released? No, rupees 2 crores will be released. And total outlay from 21-22 to 25-26 is rupees 17,417 crores. So this is also correct. So we have to identify the correct statement, which means 2 and 4 should be the correct answer. Joki again option mein nahi hai. I think yahan pe kuch typo error hai. So only 2 and 4 will be the correct answer. Option A. Okay, because we have to identify the correct statement. Second and fourth are correct. Option A, main isko PDF mein sahi kar dunga. So only 2 and 4 is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 2. Question number 2 says, as per the reservation norms for jute packing materials under JPM Act of 1987, What is this JPM? It's Jute Packing Materials only. Jute Packing Materials Act of 1987. How much percentage of food grain should be packed in jute bags? This is important for the exams where agricultural questions are asked, like IBPS SO mein pucha jata hai and of course in the NABARD. Now, JPM Act mein reservation norms ke according, kitna percent food grains pack hoga in the jute bags. So let's talk about this. So remember, Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved the reservation norms under Jute Packing Materials Act of 1987. And according to these norms, 100% food grains and 20% of sugar, 100% food grains and 20% of sugar should be packed in the jute bags. ठीक है? 100% food grains और 20% sugar जो है, वो jute bags में pack होना चाहिए. Also according to these norms, direct employment will be provided to 0.37 million workers and 4 million farmers across the country. And do remember that in India, eastern region, especially West Bengal, is a hub of jute products. You can say jute ki industry ka ye hub hai. ठीक है? So, this particular news mein, you just have to remember these two very important points. 100% food grains and 20% of sugar should be packed in the jute bags as per the reservation norms under Jute Packing Material Act of 1987. Okay. So, now let's come back to the question. They are asking regarding the food grains. So, therefore, the correct answer will be what? 100%. If the question was regarding, sugar, the answer would be 20%. Moving ahead to question number 3. How many villages will be adopted by All India Coordinated Research Project on Women in Agriculture and ICAR, Central Institute for Women in Agriculture under Nutrition Smart Village Program, which is a brand new program which has been launched by the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare headed by Narendra Singh Tomar. So this new program, Nutrition Smart Village program, has been launched by Union Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. Now, what is the objective? To develop 75 Nutri-Smart villages across the country to strengthen the Poshan Abhiyan. Poshan Abhiyan ko strengthen karne ke liye 75 villages ko Nutri-Smart village banaya jayega. Now, what is the meaning of Nutri-Smart villages? See, basically, yahan pe kya hoga? Ye jo villages honge, here nutrition campaign, nutrition awareness campaign will be conducted. ठीक है, न्यूट्रिशन अवेयरनेस कैंपेन यहाँ पे होगा, लोगों को बताया जाएगा कि क्या किस तरीके से जो न्यूट्रिशियस फूड है वो हमारी हेल्थ के लिए बेनिफिशियल होता है, एंड देयर बाय द टारगेट इज टू ओवरकम द माल न्यूट्रिशन इन द कंट्री. ऑलराइट, नाउ टॉकिंग मोर अबाउट दिस न्यूज, सो रिमेंबर टोटल 75 विलेजेस विल बी अडॉप्टेड बाय ऑल इंडिया कोऑर्डिनेटेड रिसर्च प्रोजेक्ट ऑन वुमेन इन एग्रीकल्चर एंड ICAR, याद रखना नाम, ऑल इंडिया कोऑर्डिनेटेड रिसर्च प्रोजेक्ट ऑन वुमेन इन एग्रीकल्चर एंड ICAR, सेंट्रल इंस्टीट्यूट फॉर वुमेन इन एग्रीकल्चर. सी, देयर आर 13 सेंटर्स इन 12 स्टेट्स ऑफ दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन AICRP, एंड ईच सेंटर विल अडॉप्ट 5 विलेजेस, व्हिच मींस टोटल 65 विलेज, एंड द रेस्ट ऑफ द 10 विलेजेस विल बी अडॉप्टेड बाय ICAR CIWA. ऑलराइट, एंड एज आई टोल्ड यू, इन दीज विलेजेस न्यूट्रिशनल अवेयरनेस प्रोग्राम, न्यूट्रिशन सेंसिटिव एग्रीकल्चर विल बी प्रमोटेड टू ओवरकम द problem of malnutrition in these villages, thereby strengthening the Poshan Abhiyan. So this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. The correct answer will be what? Option B, 75, because 75 villages will be adopted under the Nutrition Smart Village program launched by Union Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. Let's move ahead. Question number 4. Name the portal launched by Government of India for Electric Vehicles Act COP26, which held at Glasgow. जो कि कहाँ पे हुआ है? Glasgow में हुआ है. And who is the president of COP26? By the way, it's Mr. Alok Sharma. Alok Sharma is the chairperson of COP26. Now this portal, guys, is E Amrit. The name of the portal is what? E Amrit, and Amrit stands for Accelerated E-Mobility Revolution for India's transportation. This is the full form of Amrit, and it has been launched by Government of India during COP26, jo ki kahan pe hui hai? Glasgow mein. Now remember, this e-Amrit is a one-stop destination which will provide all the information regarding the e-vehicles. E-vehicles ke regarding sari information isme milegi, like for example, it will bust the myths of e-vehicles, information regarding the purchase, information regarding the subsidy, information regarding the policies of government with respect to the e-vehicles. Alright, and it has been developed and hosted by Niti Aayog, and it has been launched as a part of India-UK a joint roadmap 2020 which was signed by the prime minister of both the countries. Okay, so इसमें याद रखना है आपको ई अमृत, name of the portal ई अमृत, and which organization has developed it and which organization is hosting this. So it is Niti Aayog. Right, so the correct answer will be what? ई अमृत, option C. Option C, E Amrit will be the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 5. Which life insurance company has partnered with India Post Payment Bank for offering term and annuity product to customers? Now, this news was given in PIB. So that is why I am discussing it here. Generally, this type of question is being discussed by Neha ma'am, but kyunki PIB mein tha, so I have to take this. So which life insurance company ke saath, कौन सी लाइफ इंश्योरेंस कंपनी ने इंडिया पोस्ट पेमेंट बैंक के साथ पार्टनर किया है फॉर ऑफरिंग टर्म एंड एन्युटी प्रोडक्ट टू कस्टमर्स ऑफ इंडिया पोस्ट पेमेंट बैंक. इंडिया पोस्ट पेमेंट बैंक अक्रॉस इट्स 650 ब्रांचेस अक्रॉस द कंट्री. ठीक है, नाउ इन दिस पर्टिकुलर न्यूज यू डोंट हैव टू गो इनटू द डिटेल्स ऑफ दिस टर्म एंड एन्युटी प्रोडक्ट्स, लाइक व्हाट प्रोडक्ट्स दैट दे आर गोइंग टू ऑफर अंडर दिस पार्टनरशिप. ये याद रखने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है, देयर इज नो नीड टू रिमेंबर. Just remember the name of the organizations between which this partnership is conducted. So the correct answer here, guys, is Bajaj Allianz Life Insurance. This life insurance company is Bajaj Allianz Life Insurance Company, which has partnered with India Post Payment Bank for offering term and annuity products to the customers of India Post Payment Bank. All right. So option D is the correct answer. Question number 6. Basmati Export Development Foundation in collaboration with which organization has organized 75 awareness cum training programs for farmers in 7 Basmati growing states or UTs. Now in this news also, guys, we do not have to go into the details because it is nothing but an awareness cum training program of the farmers. ठीक है, तो इसमें अब awareness campaign में क्या होता है, नुक्कड़ नाटक होंगे, कुछ लोग भाषण देंगे आके, कुछ लोग लोगों को बताएंगे टेक्निक्स, तो यही सब चीजें होती है विच आर नॉट रेलेवेंट फॉर द एग्जाम. द रेलेवेंट पार्ट फॉर द एग्जाम इज दिस ओनली. बासमती एक्सपोर्ट डेवलपमेंट फाउंडेशन ने किस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के साथ मिलकर दिस अवेयरनेस कैंपेन को कंडक्ट किया था? सो रिमेंबर द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज अपीडा, ऑप्शन ए अपीडा इज द करेक्ट आंसर. मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 7. Which state government Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances has organized a regional conference on the theme strengthening the state institutes of public administration, and under this conference all the national and state public administration institutes came together to discuss ki what are the problems in the governors and how we can tackle that. Okay, and this, remember, was organized by Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances along with the government of Uttar Pradesh, option E. Uttar Pradesh is the correct answer. Chief Minister is Yogi Adityanath, of course. Question number 8 mein ek mission ka zikr hai, and the government has not provided any details of this mission. They have just said ki Dr. Jitendra Singh has launched this mission during his speech in COP26. So hame abhi utni hi information hai. So if in future, of course, iski jab details aayengi, then we will discuss that. So which mission has been launched by Dr. Jitendra Singh, who is the Minister of Science and Technology and Minister of Earth Sciences, during COP26 under Mission Innovation? Do you remember this mission has been launched under Mission Innovation? Now what will be the objective of this newly launched mission? For supporting startups to accelerate innovation in the area of renewable fuels, chemicals and materials for a low carbon future. Alright. And remember, the name of this mission, guys, is Mission Integrated Biorefineries. Option B. Mission Integrated Biorefineries is the correct answer to this question. All right. So that's it for the session today, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. I'll see you in the next session on Wednesday. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.